Why do Adventists support the United Nations agenda? In the country of Argentina, the Adventist Church has declared its support for the United Nations social agenda in spite of the UN's commitment to abortion and homosexuality. How can Adventists affirm that the Church is not condoning abortion, when in fact it allows the killing of unborn children with birth anomalies, and supports the activities of the United Nations that defends abortion as a human right? In Argentina, Adventists sign government compliance commitment to adhere to the United Nations 2030 Agenda for Sustainable Development. If you want to verify this, stop the video, copy the link and paste it in your browser. Eduardo Brau, left, is the official who gets people to sign their promises to government. Patricia Muller, center, signed in behalf of Seventh-day Adventists. Government officials in Argentina have committed to implementing the UN Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs, not only at the national level, but also within their provinces and municipalities. The River Plate Adventist University, UAP, together with other municipalities of the Entre Rios province, signed the Acts of Adhesion to the Articulation of Actions within the framework of the Sustainable Development Goals. Why do Seventh-day Adventists sign government compliance pledges to adhere to the United Nations and its globalist and secular agendas? Do we even know what the UN Sustainable Development Goals, SDGs, contain? The United Nations in its SDGs promote radical feminism. They want abortion and euthanasia to be easily accessible. They are working to advance radical gender theory, LGBT+, in all schools. They are trying to make plant and animal life equal to human life. The UN wants to annul national sovereignty by erasing borders and eliminating everyone's constitutions. The SDGs promote pantheistic environmentalism and religious syncretism. They want to end the free market economy and dissolve individual freedoms. The UN defends everything that God is against. The Church is supposed to be the agency of Christ, not the United Nations. True Seventh-day Adventists are supposed to submit to divine revelation, not to the public opinions of left-wing groups. We must bear witness to sound doctrine, not to radical globalists who reject biblical truth. The United Nations declares abortion a human right. Article 6 posits that every human being has the inherent right to life and that this right shall be protected by law. How can abortion be a human right if Article 6 states that every human being has a right to life? Does this include the unborn? Is the unborn a human being? What does science and the Adventist Church say about this? The science of abortion, when does life begin? In a recent interview, Senator Marco Rubio, RFL, declared it is a scientific fact that human life begins at conception. Do Adventists support this view? Statement on the biblical view of unborn life and its implications for abortion. Thus, human life is of inestimable value. This is true for all stages of human life, the unborn, children of various ages, adolescents, adults, and seniors independent of physical, mental, and emotional capacities. Notice that the reference to the great value of human life includes all stages of development of the unborn. God considers the unborn child as human life. Prenatal life is precious in God's sight, and the Bible describes God's knowledge of people before they were conceived. And bear in mind that the Adventist Church recognizes the humanity of the unborn, something that is denied by the defenders of abortion. But notice what this Adventist document also says. Consequently, in rare and extreme cases, human conception may produce pregnancies with fatal prospects and/or acute, life-threatening birth anomalies that present individuals and couples with exceptional dilemmas. This is where we Adventists contradict ourselves by denying the right to life to those with fatal prospects and birth anomalies. Fatal prospects means that the attending physician believes that the unborn child will likely die either prior to the birth experience or else soon after it. Experience has shown that human diagnosis has been wrong on numerous cases, and that abortion is an irreversible act. Is it morally acceptable to kill a human being because the doctor believes that the patient may not survive? The document also states, decisions in such cases may be left to the conscience of the individuals involved and their families. What if the conscience of the woman or her doctor is either faulty or damaged by sin? Is such conscience a reliable guide? Should the church blindly follow the dictates of a woman with a damaged conscience? Then the document adds, these decisions should be well informed and guided by the Holy Spirit and the biblical view of life outlined above. Will the Holy Spirit violate the divine law that prohibits the killing of an innocent human being? Can the Holy Spirit contradict the Bible? And consider the following claim, while not condoning abortion, the church and its members are called to follow the example of Jesus. Here the Adventist Church claims not to condone abortion while openly condoning the killing of those unborn children with fatal prospects and birth anomalies. This reminds me of King Saul, who claimed that he had fulfilled his mission to exterminate King Amalek, including all his animals, while Prophet Samuel could hear the bleating of sheep he had saved from destruction. King Saul thought he could outsmart the Lord, and his deviation from duty cost him his kingdom. The Lord rejected King Saul as a result of his disobedience, and he will reject his chosen people if we continue to ignore his holy law. If you believe that this could never happen to our Adventist church, then perhaps you should listen to someone who has never made a mistake. Jesus predicted that he would vomit us out of his mouth. Repentance is our only hope. There is no other alternative. Save this video. Please, share this video with your friends. And watch the videos listed below. And post your comments below.